It's New Year's Eve 2016. Good morning, gang, or good afternoon. Oh, it's afternoon now. Very late today. Look, not recording until 10 to 1. Been busy, busy, busy. Oh, yes, I've been to Waitrose this morning. Very, very busy. We had to queue to get into Waitrose, dear. The car park was absolutely jam-packed. Not that I usually go on a Saturday, but I kind of ran out of time yesterday. I was going to go shopping yesterday, so I've got a few bits and pieces in there. And came out of there, and I needed to go to Sainsbury's petrol filling station, where there are no Christmas decorations now, because they were taking them down on Christmas Eve. Did you see the show where I talked about that? Yes, when I went in Christmas Eve at 11 o'clock in the morning, there's a bloke up a ladder taking Christmas decorations. Boo-hoo to you. Boo-hoo. Humbug, humbug. Couldn't wait to get rid of them, could you, dear? Anyway, when I was coming towards Tesco, Sainsbury's, there's a little mini roundabout. And, of course, they're all queuing up to get in Sainsbury's in the main shop. But, unfortunately, the petrol filling station is the same lane. You've got to get in the same lane, OK? So the queue, I've found a way of getting around this. You'll love this. Now, take this on board. This could save you a lot of time when you're shopping, my dears. All right? So queue a mile long, trying to get in, but on the mini roundabout, there is another lane. Okay, so there's a left one. So you would turn left to go into Sainsbury's. And there's a right-hand lane where you would either go straight on or right. Okay, so seeing the queue, I'm so naughty, boys. I'm sure this is not illegal. I don't bother reporting me to the police for this. This is not illegal. Look, you're so excited. You think you're going to get me into trouble now, don't you? No. Let me tell you what to do. OK? If there's a long line there, what you do is you go in the right lane. No one in the right lane. No one in the right. It's a bit like these idiots. Idiots. Mainly Uber drivers, I think, boys and girls. Uber drivers who at night will not go in the bus lane. Have you seen them? It clearly indicates on signs, bus lane, 7 a.m. till 10 a.m. 2 o'clock in the morning, they still won't go in it. Can you read English, dear? God's sake, man. But that doesn't bother me, because I'm just in the bus lane. I go straight past all the cars to the lights and away. Nothing illegal there. And similarly, nothing illegal this morning to jump the queue trying to get into the Sainsbury's petrol filling station. So, as I say, little mini roundabout in front of me. Queue a mile long on the left. On the right, no queue. Not a single person. Goes on the right. Gets to the mini roundabout. Indicates right. All around the mini roundabout. And straight in. Bye-bye, people. And they're all sitting there like this. Oh, what do I do? I've got to sit in the queue. People are so stupid. I'm really... This has been the year not only of terrible amount of wonderful people that we've lost, but also of the year of stupidity. It really is. Next year, no one's going to be offended and no one's going to be stupid. You don't believe me, do you? You don't believe me. In fact, I noticed that the lovely Wendy, who sent me a wonderful, wonderful email this morning. It was a private email, but she sent me such a nice email this morning. And thank you very much, Wendy, for sending that. I really do appreciate that, my day. All right. But I noticed on her wall, she's got a New Year's Eve resolution. Similar to the one that I mentioned yesterday. Did you hear yesterday's New Year's Eve resolution? Oh, no, we missed yesterday's show. Oh, well, then, you know, if you're going to disappear now and again, you will miss things. This is like a book. This is like an old, really, this is like the Old Testament, this programme. It just goes on and on. It really does. And if you miss something, you won't get into heaven. You won't get into heaven. So please, this is a lovely new shirt, incidentally, as purchased for me by my niece, Tracy. Thank you, Tracy, for this. I should have ironed it first, really. It's large, a little bit tighter, to be honest. I've just weighed myself. I put on weight. I don't know how that's that. Well, I do. My sister's homemade fudge and orange creams. I've had a bag already. Isn't that terrible? She only gave them. When did I bring them home? Oh, gosh. Tuesday. I only bought them home Tuesday. Great big bags. You know, not like one of those things that you buy in a box. 3 pieces of fudge in there. Oh, where's it all gone? Oh, you've eaten it, you greedy git. Here, so listen. Wendy Young's New Year's Eve resolution. to unfriend... This is very good, actually. To unfriend everyone who can't be bothered to check Google first to see if what they are reposting or resending are hoaxes or not. That includes messages I receive in private. This is my pet peeve, and it drives me insane. Wendy is being driven insane by you, dear. You! Sending news stories that are 200 years old. Oh, if you don't cut and replace this, Facebook will start charging you £75 per year. What a load of old rubbish. Why can't you check things, dears, before you repost them? I mean, it's common sense, especially those of you who are over the age of 40 or 50. You should know better. It's understandable with these idiots that have been to university. It really is. Oh, we're really intelligent. We've got backs with honours and all that. Oh, okay, mate. Well done for you. So how much is that? And they're working at McDonald's. Not that there's anything with working at McDonald's. You've still got a job. But, you know, if you've got those qualifications, why haven't you got another job? Because you've got no common sense. That's why, dear. How many times, dear? Okay, can you do this for me? I've got to ask the manager about that. No common sense whatsoever. And that's what's missing, dear. And it's the same with the people on the Facebook. We see that, what's going on? If you don't pass this on, your house is going to explode in 20 minutes. Oh, I better quickly cut and repaste that. How stupid can you be, dear? Come on. Dear me, not that I'm one to moan, as you well know. I'm very calm and relaxed at all times. Hopefully, Wendy says, I will still have some friends left at the end of the year. Do not worry about that, my darling. Do not worry. I will still be here as sensible as ever. Completely unintelligent, but nevertheless full of common sense. Thank you very much. Unlike my mate Ron. Oh, please don't make me tell you. Hush my mouth and my lip. Horses wouldn't draw it from me. Okay, I'll let you know. So yesterday, he had to go to a shop to collect some stuff for someone. So he's filled out his trolley, got to the till, left his wallet at home. And it's like a 45-minute drive. Oh, dear Ronnie. Do try and remember your wallet, especially when you come round here. You know, oh, he's terrible. If he have, you know, because generally when I'm out shopping, I never bring enough money out with me. And I'm like, oh, have you got a couple of quid, dear? I'm just a bit short of £2. And you get in the door. My God, he's up here looking for the two. Where's my £2? Where's my £2? Oh, it's terrible, dear. But he forgets his own money. He got all the way. And the times he's gone, like we'd be in the swimming pool changing room. Because he swims with me. I mean, when he gets in, the water gets out. Put it that way, dear. I mean, he says I look a bit fat, but blimey, have you seen him, dear? Anyway, so he gets in the pool and then it'll be, oh, I think I've left my phone in the car. And he has to go back to the phone. Very, very forgetful. Unlike me, I remember everything, boys and girls. I remember everything. Don't you worry if you've ever crossed me in any way at all. I will remember. And, you know, you bring it up years later. I mean, decades later, I bring things up. Oh, how do you remember that? Don't you worry. I've remembered when I lent you 50 pence back in 1975 and you didn't pay me back. You think I've forgotten? I don't think so. No. So can we please have a bit of common sense here? And actually, the thing that makes me unfriend, and I never tell them, what makes me unfriend people is when people put a little comment up there saying, oh, I'm going to have a friend, something like, I'm going to have a cull on Facebook. I'm going to unfriend people. They don't actually put that. I'm going to see who puts a comment underneath this to see who's watching today. Otherwise, I will unfriend you. I've only got to see that and click, gone. Not only unfriended, sometimes blocked as well. So there we are. So don't think you're very important. I'm not an important person. Neither are you. Don't put those comments on there. Otherwise, you will be unfriended. And I suggest you do the same, boys and girls. Do the same to people. You know, if you have a little look. Oh, you know, I don't know. No, off with their heads. What? That's Marie Antoinette. Is that right idea? No, Queen. Oh, who cut the heads off? Queen Elizabeth. She cut heads off. She had the right idea. Didn't like someone. What? Cut the head off. Ha, ha, ha. Now, there's a very important email here. It's very, very important because I have forgotten. Have I told you all about Waitrose now and the Sainsbury's thing? Yes, I've told you about that, haven't I? Very important from Mari, right? Because she sent this in on the 25th of December, Christmas Day, and I've missed it. Sometimes I go back through old emails just to check I haven't missed anything. And occasionally I do miss something. So I must apologise in my full capacity and apologisingness to do this. Happy Christmas. Hi, Chris. I loved watching your opening Christmas bit, which is gone now. That very generous Christmas gift from Eloise and Rachel and Anne that is hanging on my wall there. You know about that, don't you? What do you mean you don't know about it? You've missed a show then, haven't you? I just told you this is what happens when you miss shows. If you miss shows, you miss something. Who knows? I mean, just a few days ago, we gave away a holiday for two in Barbados. If you'd have been there, you might have won it. Oh, well, never mind. Maybe next time. How wonderful it was. I was so touched how grateful they were. Oh, absolutely. They really were. They are grateful people. You really do deserve the best. And the girls obviously think the same. Oh, isn't that nice? That's nice. Thank you for all the pleasure you give to everyone with your daily shows. Sending love and best wishes for you for 2017. And that's from Mari. So thank you very much for that, Mari. That's a lovely email. Can I just kiss this piece of paper? Would you like a little kiss this morning? Who wants a kiss? Come closer. Come closer. Come closer. And listen. There you are. There's your last kiss of 2016, my darlings. All right. Another couple of messages here. Good morning to... Stand by, please. Good morning to new viewer. We have Joanna Evola. Now, I was a little bit concerned, Joanna. When I saw the word Evola, I thought Ebola. And I thought you might be a member of a religious fanatical organisation about to send me something like Ebola in the post or something like that in a small test tube. Yes, you need to be very... Check your mail very carefully, boys and girls. You don't know. How easy would that? You know, you're just casually opening. Oh, that's a bill. Put that in the bin. That's a bill. There's a little package, one of those padded envelopes. Well, I mean, I suppose you could use a padded bra, could you? Could you use a padded bra to send stuff through the post like that? Anyway, a padded envelope, and you open it, that's a little test tube. And unbeknown, you probably think that test tube is, you know, a sample of some expensive exotic perfume or something like that. Have you seen the price of some of these perfumes? Oh, dear, I don't wear it. I don't wear aftershave, really, or perfumes. I've got this lemon spray stuff that I spray all over myself, generally when I get into it. But, you know, after a couple of minutes, you can't smell it anyway. What's all that about? I quite like lemon. Although you've got to be careful. You know, there is some lemon fragrance that ends up making you smell like a toilet. You know, like toilet duck. Do you use that stuff? Toilet duck. I've got that little one. It comes in like a long thing. And you kind of push it and it moves down one more. And then you do that and tick, and it sticks something to the side of the toilet and it makes it all smell fresh and nice. Although you've got to be careful with children, right? Because some of it does smell quite sweet and you don't want... Paris the thought. You don't want your child or grandchild going in the toilet, picking this thing off the side of the toilet bowl and trying to eat it. Oh, no, dear. Very dangerous. Very dangerous. Don't put them in there. I would say don't put that sort of thing if you've got children. But if you haven't put one up, put several up there and it smells so lovely. It goes nicely with my new light. I've got a light in my toilet bowl that Adam the plumber bought me. Oh, yes, it's very good. And it lights up. Actually, what, do you want to see it? Come on, have a look. Here is my light up toilet. Isn't that fantastic? As you approach the toilet, detector here detects movement in the middle of the night and illuminates your toilet so that you don't have those embarrassing little accidents on the grey carpet or whatever it is on the floor there. So that's what you absolutely need, one of these wonderful light up toilets. And thank you very much to Adam the plumber for purchasing this for me for Christmas. It's good, isn't it? You like that, don't you? You want one of those. They're about, I don't know how much they are. I would imagine around about... I didn't look up the price. Do you want me to have a look? Oh, that's a bit naughty, isn't it? Looking up the price of gifts. Oh, yeah, but you want to know, don't you? Hang on a second. 1 minute. Light up toilet bowl. Light up toilet. Let's try light up toilets. LED. Ah, there it is. Here it is. Oh, you can get them on eBay. £2.98 on eBay. I get everything on Amazon now. Hang on, let's see how much they are on Amazon. What's it? Light up toilet bowl, I said, didn't I? 1 moment, please. I hope you... Have you got up your Amazon one-click ordering? We like that. Light up toilet. I haven't had my dinner yet, dear. Light up... Oh, there it is. Ah, on Amazon. Different things. They're all the same thing. Just look for the cheapest one. I'm coming at about £6.58. Okay, £6.58 on Amazon. And this thing, you just saw it. Fantastic. Only £6.58 with free UK delivery. Oh, yes. You need one of those. Where's that email gone? Joanna, you need one of those in your toilet, my love. Eh? You need something like that. So, yes, do watch out. I thought your name was Joanna Ebola and you had sent me, or you were about to send me, as a religious fanatic, Ebola in a test tube. You know, it's not funny. Not fun. I bet people have tried that before. I bet people have sent people like important people, politicians and that, stuff in the post. I'm sure that if you were a politician, you wouldn't open your own letters, surely. I can't believe Theresa May opens her own letters. I mean, As a great fan of the beautiful Theresa May, I would willingly volunteer to open her letters for her. Yes, and if you're sending anything mucky to her, apart from the evilness through test tubes and things like that, if you're sending any disgustingly dirty letters, they won't get past my nose. I'm not having Theresa May subjected to the disgusting filth that you might send her. Pictures of your bits and pieces. How disgusting is that, dear? It really is. So, Joanna says, Chris, I love your show. Very new to your show from the States. Whereabouts in the States are you, my darling? Do let us know, okay? Totally enjoy. You're a pleasure to watch. It's all very light-hearted, Joanna. Very, very light-hearted. And that's what this little program is all about. It's like a friend on the other side of the camera. Okay, that's what it is. So welcome to the show. Do let us know in the States where you are, because we've got quite a few people in the States. Lots of Manilow people are in the States as well. All right, so welcome along, Joanna. Hello to James Clark, who says, hi, thanks for the birthday message yesterday. Have you got anything on this evening in London? Yes. I'm working on this New Year's Eve at Central Station. I should be doing some DJing there. I'm actually not quite sure what time I start and finish this evening. So I'm just going to turn in at the usual time. It's a Saturday and usually I start at 9:30 on a Saturday night. Just to let you know, if you're coming along tonight, it's £12.50, a little bit more expensive than usual to be expected on New Year's Eve. But I think you'll find that pretty cheap in comparison with a lot of the other places. My nephew is paying, I think, £60 or £70 to go somewhere. But he's got like this VIP thing where they get free shots, bottles of champagne and that sort of thing. So it's £12.50 to come in, James. This is in Central Station, Wharfdale Road in King's Cross. Now, if you ring up, I don't think you can do this on the door, but if you ring up and sort of now and say you want dinner as well, you can have a sit down, slap up meal and entry for £25, which I think is blooming good. And let me tell you, when you have a meal in Central Station, Wharfdale Road in King's Cross, you're not hungry. You won't be wanting a bag of crisps afterwards. It's not like those posh restaurants. Oh, isn't that awful, dear? You're sitting there, you know, oh, can I have the steak and kidney pie, please, and some chips? And this plate arrives with this tiny thing in the middle and one chip. Yeah, £250, please. I don't think so, darling. I don't think so. No, you will not be hungry after a meal at Central Station. And often I got free chips last night because it's Christmas. I was given free chips by the lovely man upstairs. So I'm very, very pleased about that. So if you're coming tonight, OK, it's £25 if you want a nice big slap up meal as well. I think that's between 8 and 9:30, the meal. I'm not quite sure of the times there, to be honest. Do you want me to look? I'll have a look. Let's have a look. Let's see if I can find anything on the Facebook thing. No, they haven't updated that today. Oh, don't know. Don't know. Anyway, ring them. Ring them. Do you want the phone number? I haven't got the phone number. You have to look it up, darling. You have to look up the phone number, OK, for Central Station. And that's tonight. All right. So thank you for the message, James. Congratulations to Craig Adams this morning, who lets me know he had a nice message from Tony Blackburn this morning. How fabulous is that? Wishing him a happy new year. That's nice. And I haven't had a personal message yet from the great Tony Blackburn. There is only one DJ, and that is Tony Blackburn, who incidentally is back tonight on BBC Radio 2. 88 to 91 FM. This is Radio 2 from the BBC. He's back on there tonight at 8 o'clock, which is great because that's exactly the time I'm driving into work tonight. So he's on at 8 o'clock tonight. And then he's back tomorrow on BBC Radio London with his excellent soul show. And then back on Friday mornings, I think, at 10 o'clock on BBC Radio Berkshire. So Tony Blackburn is back on the BBC. And of course, he's got his shows on Thames Radio and Red Dragon Radio, and lots of radio stations on Sunday he does, mainly up north, I think. I can't remember what the... Oh, I think it's great. The Greatest Hits. I think there might be a radio network called The Greatest Hits, and he's on there on Sunday. Congratulations, Craig Adam. That is fantastic. Absolutely fantastic, that is. Really is. Some messages from yesterday's show. Simon says, my favourite George Michael song is I Don't Want a Threesome, I Don't Want to Let Two Girls Down. Very, very good. We had some people singing some George Michael songs last night, which was rather marvellous. It really was. Actually, DJ Chris sung a very good version of... I can't remember the title now. La da 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 da. Oh, what was the song? I can't remember. But anyway, he sung one. David B sung maybe one or two songs. I think we had another lady in there last night. Oh, she was lovely. Now, what was her name? Athena. Greek mythological god of wisdom. Athena. Oh, she was lovely. What a happy lady. I've never seen her before. I have seen her before. She has been in before. But for some reason, I took notice of her last night. And she was up dancing around. Such a nice lady. You must come to one of our karaoke nights at Central Station. They're Monday. Monday between 8 and 11:30, including bank holiday, OK? Come along bank holiday. You'll get cheap drinks and karaoke on Monday night, bank holiday, and every Monday between 8 and 11:30 p.m. So it doesn't finish too late. You get up to work tomorrow, the next day. And also every Friday night between 8:30 and 11 p.m. All right. Poor old Lily last night. Lily, she was there with her husband last night. Lily, and she sang a couple of songs. And did you do a George Michael song? I can't remember now, Lily. But her husband has left his glasses there. You know how dear glasses are. Unless, of course, like me, you get the supermarket ones for like £5. Look at these. There's nothing wrong with these. These are supermarket glasses. Look, everything has suddenly become clearer. You're looking particularly gorgeous today, I must say. Especially you over there. So Lily's husband left his glasses there. And she sent me a message. But I sent her one back. What do you want me to do? But unfortunately, she was a little bit late sending me a message back. So in the end, instead of taking them home, I gave them to the barman, Jordan. So they should be behind the bar for you there, Lily. Now, I wonder if you want me to pick them up tonight and I'll look after them. Would you like me to do that? I'll take a glass case with me. Is that one there? I'll take a glass case with me and I'll pick them up for you if you instruct me to do so, OK? So I put that on the floor. Anything that needs to happen goes on the floor there, so it can't be ignored. You see, I'll trip over that instead of ignore it. All right, Lily? Let's have a look there. Rachel. Good morning, Rachel. Rachel says, we were talking about Anne Taplin's mansion. She lives in a big mansion. Apparently, it's not Anne's house at all. It's Rachel's. So I don't know where I got that idea from. Rachel has got the big mansion with 25 bedrooms and integral bathroom. What's that called? Integral bathrooms in a bedroom. Oh, what's that? What's that called? Not cul-de-sac, is it, darling? Integral bedrooms. Oh, what do you call that? You know when a bedroom's got like a bathroom attached to it? Oh, you're shouting at the television now, aren't you, dear? Shouting at the television. No, I can't remember. All sweets. That's it. Oh, thank you for shouting. I heard you then, you see. You see, if you shout loud enough, sometimes I can hear you. All sweet. That's it. All sweet. Yes, she's got all sweet bathrooms in all of them, dear. How marvellous. It must take you ages to clean that place, Rachel. Oh, sorry, dear. You've got many staff to carry out those tasks for you, haven't you? Thank you very much. All right. We're going to do today's birthdays. Never got onto any news stories today, did we? Never mind, dear. Have I done all the messages? I haven't got time to tell you this now. Have I? No, I'll save it for tomorrow. Let me put that on there. Number one. Now, we might do a live show at some point tomorrow, okay? So keep an eye out on your little Facebook things. We might do a live show tomorrow. If we do, it will be either afternoon or evening. Won't be in the morning because it's church in the morning, dear. Oh, yes, dear. Got to go church in the morning. Church in the morning on a Sunday. So it will be either afternoon or evening tomorrow to do some sort of live show. But I've got to tell you a bit of a story. Very, very dangerous, dear. I'm lucky to be here today. I nearly died yesterday. No one cares. Look, you're just laughing. Please, will you not laugh at these serious things, dear? I'm not here to be mocked. I'm not here. Television personality. I'm not here to be mocked. I shall tell you tomorrow how lucky I am to be here today. Nearly died. No one cares. Look, you're just laughing. Why do I bother? I'll tell you, why do I bother? Right, one more little extra. Oh, no, we haven't done the birthdays. And then there's something after the birthdays. Don't go yet. I know some of you switch off because it's not your birthday. But don't go until the end, because something extra for you today, boys and girls. Happy birthday today to Guy Bentley. Now, Guy, you're very lucky that I know about your birthday, because it hasn't come up on the Facebook. And then, after further inquiries on your Facebook wall, I noticed you haven't set a birthday. So, and that goes for anyone else. If you haven't got a birthday on your Facebook, I don't know where it is. And therefore, we can't sing you happy birthday. So you're very lucky, Guy, that your little boyfriend, little Ricky, he called me a strange person last night. Strange. Am I a strange person? Happy birthday today to Guy Bentley. It doesn't say. I reckon you're about 30... Early 30s, 32, 31, 32, something like that. I'm guessing you are, Guy. Happy birthday. Guy is one of our managers, actually, at Central Station. And he's the top man. He's really a top man. So happy birthday to you, Guy, OK? Happy birthday today to my little friend, Joseph Mark Gerling. Happy birthday, Joe. Now, Joe used to come to a place that I worked in Earls Court. I'm going back here. Oh, my word. 89, 90. I must be going back here. 25, 28 years, somewhere around there, I'm going back. Happy birthday, Joe. I don't know how old you are today. I think you were going to try and get into politics. So how's that going? I haven't spoken to you for some time. Little Joe, happy birthday. You'll always be little Joe to me. All right, happy birthday, Joe. Happy birthday today to Nigel Taylor, to Marcus James Lewis, who's 40 years old today. Marcus, I'm just having a look on your Facebook cover picture. Is that me, dear, that you've got dancing like that in the background? That does look. It's my sort of shape. It really is. Happy birthday, Marcus. Okay, happy birthday today to Patti O'Dores. 45 today. Still young, Patti, darling. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to Bien Jamienz, who's 28 today. To Andy Coupland, who's 56 today, and to Geno, hello Geno, where have you been hiding, darling? Oh, look, you look like it. Are you running a marathon there, dear? You look like I'm looking at some of your photos as I'm doing this. In one photo, look like you're running a marathon, and then in another one, you're smoking a cigarette, dear. You must give up the smoking, my love. Stop smoking with United Kingdom Talk. We can all give up together. Oh, I don't smoke. How about if I start smoking today? Then tomorrow it can be my New Year's resolution to give up again, couldn't it? Anyway, happy birthday, everyone. Here comes the song.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, lovely people. Happy birthday to you. That must be quite good, having your birthday on New Year's Eve. You know, you've got the free party and all that as well. Now, as it's New Year's Eve, where's my slippers gone? Just a moment, please. I always keep losing a slipper. There it is. I lose a slipper. Okay, as it's New Year's Eve, let us depart to the piano downstairs. Thank you very much. Well, you're probably not watching this exactly at midnight on New Year's Eve, New Year's Day. So, this being the official New Year's Eve United Kingdom Talk television spectacular programme, I shall sing for you Auld Lang Syne to go out with the show today. Now, if you know the words, join in, boys and girls. Are you ready? Should old acquaintance be forgot and never brought to mind? Should old acquaintance be forgot and old time? For old lang syne, my joke, for old lang syne, we'll take a cup of kindness yet for old lang syne. Verse 2, for surely take a cup of kindness yet for Auld Lang Syne. For Auld Lang Syne, my job, for Auld Lang Syne, we'll take a cup of kindness yet for the sake of Auld Lang Syne. Happy 2007 for you, and thank you so much for spending some time with me this year. Hope you can do the same again next year. Happy New Year! Cheerio.